Hello everyone and welcome to One Academy. In this lecture, we are going to talk about excretion in a very brief manner. So first, what is excretion? It is the process of removal of nitrogenous metabolic wastes from our body. So there are various different kinds of wastes that are being produced in our body due to the metabolic processes that are occurring in our body. One of the waste products can be the carbon dioxide which is produced, and it is handled by the lungs, which would remove it out through exhalation process. There are other wastes also. Some of the waste or some amount of urea as well, which is another waste, is removed by the sweat, but major amount of urea is removed through our kidneys. This is one of the waste products. Now, what are these wastes? What are the other wastes that require the excretion process through kidneys? Are ammonia. Ammonia is a very important product during the protein metabolism. Whatever protein are synthesized, they are changed from one form to another form, from one protein to another protein. All these produces a large amount of ammonia. This ammonia is highly toxic if it is there in its form in our body. So this ammonia is converted into a less toxic form, that is urea, and then it is excreted through the kidneys. So this is one of the major waste product of our body. Another is urea, which is produced by the ammonia only. We are also going to deal with the process how ammonia is converted to urea. Then we have uric acid. Uric acid is another type, and this is mostly in the crystallized form. It is not produced in mammals as such, but in other organisms, like in case of birds, uric acid is one of the major nitrogenous metabolic waste excreted out in the form of pellets. Then we have xanthines. Now these xanthines are produced by the metabolism of the nucleotides. The nucleotide metabolism is a process where the various different nucleotides, the nucleotides are getting degraded, and this degradation of these nucleotides leads to a product called as xanthine, which is again poisonous and need to be removed. Next is guanine, which is also another waste of the nucleotides, degeneration or the decomposition of nucleotides. Then is the creatinine. Now our muscles store the ATP in the form of creatinine phosphate, and whenever we require this ATP, we take this ATP from this creatine phosphate, which converts ADP to ATP. So creatine serves as a storehouse for ATP in our body, but whenever it is required, it is converted to ATP. Now this is basically, creatinine is produced from creatine phosphate, which is present in the muscles. So excess of it has to be eliminated. So this is done by converting this creatine phosphate into creatinine. So if a person has excess of creatinine, it denotes a particular kidney disorder. So all these waste products needs to be removed outside our body, because they are really toxic if they are present in large amounts. So this process is carried out by the kidneys. Now, what are the classification of different types of organisms? And this classification is on the basis of excretory product that they secrete or excrete. First is the ammonotelic organisms. Ammonotelic organisms have ammonia as their excretory product. Now, as I already told you that ammonia is a highly toxic product, and it can be excreted only when there is a large amount of water. It requires large amount of water for excretion. But human beings, they don't have that ample of water, so ammonia cannot directly be excreted from our body. But it can be done in case of fishes and aquatic organisms like hydra and bony fishes. So because it requires a large amount of water, because it is highly toxic and water dilutes this toxicity, that is the reason why water is required for its excretion. Then we have the ureotelic organisms, where urea is the excretory product. Now ammonia is getting converted to urea in case of ureotelic organisms. Ammonia is the basic product that is formed due to the protein metabolism, and it has to be converted to urea in case of ureotelic organism. Why? Because ammonia is more toxic, urea is less toxic, and it can be removed easily from the body. The example of organisms that are ureotelic is cartilaginous fishes, amphibians, and mammals. Now, it requires lesser amount of water. Then we have the uricotelic organisms, where uric acid crystals are the excretory products. Here no water is required at all. So this kind of excretion is required in organisms who have to conserve water. For example, birds. Birds have to fly long distances and they have to conserve water in their body. So they excrete out uric acid crystals, which are called as pellets. And also this is seen in case of reptiles and cockroaches. So all these organisms are uricotelic. So now, as we have done the classification, now we will come to the types of kidneys. What are the different types of kidneys? There's an archenephric kidney, which is arche means something which is ancestral. So archenephric kidneys are ancestral form of kidneys found in the larva of cyclostomes, because these are some ancestral organisms. So these type of kidneys are found in cyclostome. Now what if these are the ancestral types of kidney, they were not that highly modified as the metanephric kidneys, which are the most advanced form. So they had a very simplified way. They did have nothing but just the glomeruli, that are the blood vessels, and there was no capsule which surrounded it. It was simply the glomeruli, and there was simply the renal tubule which were going to carry the wastes from the glomeruli, and the process was done. Then we have the pronephric kidneys. Pronephric kidneys, they were a bit more advanced than the archenephric. Here these were present in the larval forms, like they were present in the tadpole of frog, and they had the nephrosomes or the ciliated funnels. Ciliated funnels were actually a part of the renal tubules that carry the wastes from the glomeruli. Next is the mesonephric kidneys. Mesonephric kidneys had the Bowman's capsule. So as compared to archenephric, they were highly advanced form because they did not have the capsules. Here the capsules are finally present. And also with respect to pronephric kidneys, they are advanced. Example is fish and frog. Finally comes the most advanced form of kidneys, that are the metanephric kidneys, which had a proper Bowman's capsule, the glomeruli, and the whole renal tubule with the Henle's loop also present. Example, reptiles, birds, and mammals. Now I was talking about urea cycle, which is the cycle of converting the whatever present ammonia into the urea, because urea is less toxic, ammonia being more toxic. So basically it occurs in the ureotelic organisms who have to secrete out or excrete out urea. This is also called as Krebs-Hanslet cycles or the ornithine cycle. Now this, we just need to learn about the simple steps of the urea cycle. This is the protein catabolism, which leads to the formation of ammonia. This ammonia then forms carbamoyl phosphate in the presence of carbon dioxide and ATP, or you have it is given carbonate ions, but it is carbon dioxide or carbonate ions and ammonia in the presence of ATP or some enzyme, they will be forming carbamoyl phosphate. This carbamoyl phosphate then combines with ornithine in the presence of another enzyme to form citrulline. Now this citrulline joins aspartic acid and changes to arginosuccinate, as we can see. Further, this arginosuccinate breaks to give arginine and fumarate. Then this arginine further enters the cycle, and with the help of an enzyme called arginase, it converts back to ornithine and urea. It is actually hydrolyzed into urea and ornithine, and thus urea is formed and ornithine is regenerated. So this is a cyclic process. So this is all about the basics of excretion. I hope you like it. Thanks for watching.